Today, we're going to be talking about how to write a job description today on The Journey. Crafting a compelling job description is really key to getting the most qualified candidates.
Yeah, and keep in mind, you do want to be concise, but be sure you're specific about what the role is. What are you hiring for so you actually get the right person? And think about it. It might seem tedious, like, oh, I got to put all this time into crafting the right description, but think about all the time that you could be saving yourself by actually getting the right person versus hiring the wrong candidate. And then the next one, and then the next one.
All right, so now let's get into our tips. Number one, focus on the end results first. So writing a job description for a full-time employee compared to a contractor, it's totally different. So with a contractor, you want to make sure that, you know, you just give them enough information, thinking about where you want to go, and they are the experts. So you don't have to line things out for them play by play. Focus on them actually telling you how we're going to get to where you want to go.
So next up, pinpoint a price point. And think about it. You don't want to put that salary too low or too high. Too low, you might undersell the job. Too high could also lead to problems as well. So think about it. What is that average amount that you think will be paid for the salary for that job? Have that in the description.
And do know that this could actually weed out a lot of the other contractors you don't want to hear from. And really, you just get inquiries from those that you really want to work
with. Yeah, because I know, I mean, I've been with GoDaddy since 2013, so it's been a while. But I know for me, like when I was looking for a job, I knew right away, like, hey, not going to go any lower than this. So it's going to help weed out people, like Sam was saying.
So next, you want to consider your project workflow. Now, you may have an idea of how you want things to go, but be very careful, because if you start to tell a contractor when and where they can work, the IRS may come back at you and say, hey, that's actually an employee, so you'll have to actually file for back, you know, payroll taxes, so you don't want to do that. So leave it open and allow the contractor to just work as they would. Again, you already said in the beginning where your end result is going to be.
Mm-hmm. So when you put together that job description, don't ask for a unicorn. Mm. And maybe you're a little confused by what I mean by that. We were just talking about this earlier. You know, so you can still ask for a candidate that's going to totally wow and amaze you, but don't ask for someone who has all these different experiences.
Like a graphic designer who's also edits videos, takes the videos, markets on social media. No, it's too much.
It's too much. So don't ask for a unicorn.
So for our last tip, you want to publish your job description where it'll make the most sense. There's no point in putting all this effort into getting the perfect job description if no one's going to see it. So reach out to those who are other business owners or managers whom can now put your job description in front of the right people or other freelancers you might know. They can send it out to their network. Another place, you can actually put your job description on LinkedIn. You can actually have people share that post and say, hey, I'm looking for a copywriter, say, in Seattle. Well, that can be seen as like a signal boost to actually get more eyes on that description. All right, so that's a wrap. You just learned how to write a job description. Make sure that you like and comment on this video.
Be sure to subscribe and ring that bell so you know when we have another video out. This is The Journey.